San Miguel Corporation President and CEO Ramon Ang meanwhile says he respects President Bongbong Marcos's decision to veto the Bulacan ecozone bill, but he hopes issues regarding the measure can still be worked out. That's as he claims the project will potentially earn $200 billion a year from investments in various industries. Ang adds the 740 billion peso airport and the creation of an ecozone will help solve a lot of transport and economic issues. San Miguel is funding the new Manila International Airport and what it dubbed a green design and future-ready aero city.
The family of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. split over his decision to veto the Bulacan Ecozone Bill. His sister, Senator Amy Marcos, says she was shocked by the move, but she respects it. The senator sponsored the measure in the upper chamber.
Maling signos ito para sa ating mga investor, whether local or foreign, para sa akin, kung sino man mag-i-invest na negosyante ngayon, bongga talaga, tulungan na natin, please. I pray that there's no chilling effect.
But the president's son, Ilocos Norte Representative Sandro Marcos, backs his father's move.
This administration would like to support whatever economic incentives that the legislature puts forward. But that requires also to be in line with that of the executive agenda. As you know, the increase for the next budget, I believe, is only around 200 billion. In other words, our revenue streams have to be as high as possible. I guess the tax breaks were too liberal.
As for some residents of Bulacan Town, they welcome the decision of Marcos. They say while they are in favor of the airport project, they were not consulted about the creation of an ecozone which could displace them. The new Philippine Transportation Secretary vows to address issues hounding land transport under his watch. Secretary Jaime Bautista says the current land transport situation in the country is unacceptable. The former Philippine Airlines president also wants to transform the transport industry and elevate it to global standards.
Nung pinag-uusapan namin ang mga problema, sabi ng presidente, ayusin natin kaagad ang problema. Nakita namin na yung experience ng ating mananakay, lalo na dito sa ETSA, ay talaga namang hindi acceptable sa gobyerno ng ating bagong Pangulo, President Bongbong Marcos. Sabi ko sa mga tao namin sa PAL, siguraduhin natin na ang serbisyo natin ay kaparehas ng serbisyo ng other foreign successful airlines. No? And ginawa po namin yan. No? Organized a team, yung tinatawag namin na customer experience team. Yan po ang aking inspirasyon at gagamitin po natin ang aking experience para mapaganda natin ang transport system, not only sa air but sa land, sa rail at sa sea po.
The Commission on Audit tells the Light Rail Transit Authority to blacklist contractors that have failed to complete projects within their target dates. In their 2021 annual audit report of the LRTA, COA noted 13 out of 22 Line 2 rehabilitation projects were not finished on time. The projects cost 984 million pesos, and the delays range from 77 to over 1,000 days. State auditors now recommend LRTA should blacklist contractors in delayed projects or initiate an immediate takeover process of several projects if necessary. The Philippine Supreme Court affirms a 2013 order of the Energy Regulatory Commission approving a request by power distributor Meralco to impose a staggered power rate hike totaling 22.6 billion pesos. The High Court voted 6-5, junking the separate petitions of Bayanhuna and the National Association of Electricity Consumers for reforms. The groups had challenged the supposed lack of due process and the ERC's alleged grave abuse of discretion in unilaterally approving the increase. The request for the power rate hike stemmed from the shutdown of the Malampaya operations and the scheduled maintenance of their power generation plants. The rate hike was never implemented after the Supreme Court issued several temporary restraining orders until indefinitely halting the increase in April 2014. In junking the petitions, the High Court said the ERC acted within the confines of its authority. Meralco says it has yet to receive the order. Bayan Muna says the order could have come at a worse time, but the prices of basic commodities still skyrocketing due to high fuel prices.